Psalm 56, verses 5-7. David sees the plotting of his accusers during his life. Jesus. So we're looking at it from now, Christological. So, right. David was seeing the plotting of his accusers, which would have been Saul and then probably the Philistines. But we're now putting a Christological view. Jesus, too, saw the plotting of his accusers during his life, and especially during his passion. And in 70 AD, there was a recompense of the crime of refusing the Savior's hand of mercy. Sometimes we, you know, God does not want anyone to be saved. Goodness knows he doesn't want that more than you or I or anybody. I mean, because, right, he knows the reality of it in a way you and I do not. But he isn't going to force his will on to another. And you make a choice, and he's going to let you have your choice, even if it's a very, you know, very, very sorrowful choice. Always worthwhile to remind ourselves of what Athanasius, he was one of those stalwarts against Irenaeus. I think he was exiled 5 times. Wow. Against the Arian heresy. We talked a little bit about Arius last time. So Athanasius to Marcellinus on reading the Psalms. Moreover, whatever your particular need or trouble from this same book, and he means all 150 Psalms, you can select a form of words to fit it so that you do not merely hear and then pass on, but, and here's the application for us today, but learn the way to remedy your ill. So the Psalms teach us how to remedy our troubles. And in this case, it's going to be how do we handle persecutions in our life?
Yeah. I love that. I was thinking, too, about how we were talking about David's position as king and how the transition was slow as he was afraid of Saul capturing him. And in the same, he was aware of the prophecy and his position and anointing to be king. And I think that offered so much confidence and trust in his remembering that I'm not going to be captured. I'm not going to be killed. God is with me because he said of me, I'm going to be king. And trusting in that prophecy and anointing, I think, is something that we're invited to do ourselves in remembering our position as God's kids. And, you know, we have value in heaven.
That is right. That is exactly right. That's exactly right. And we're going to remember those wise words because that's going to be part of the solution, the remedy to our ill, as Athanasius would say. Would you be so kind to read for us verses 1 and 2 again to kind of, it's been a while since we last heard the words, right?
Absolutely. Be gracious to me, O God, for man tramples on me. All day long an attacker oppresses me. My enemies trample on me all day long, for many attack me proudly.
Excellent. So right out of the gate, David has this expectation that God is gracious in spite of his problems. And he's also saying something, he's stating something that's very true. Evildoers often not only seem to get the goods, but they boast about it. David is pointing out that pride in sin is vicious. It's one thing, we all fall short of the glory of God, and we all are sinners in need of a Savior. That's, you know, the human condition. There's a different level of evil, though, when we want to say that sin is now good, when we boast in that sin. We have now made, right, because then it's gone from sin to vice. And when we're practicing vice, we're vicious. So that term vicious is, of course, the root is in vice. So when we have now made a, so when you're boasting, so when the evildoers are boasting, right, and they fight against me proudly, we're dealing with some vicious sorts here. Verses 3 and 4, please.
When I am afraid, I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I praise, in God I trust. I shall not be afraid. What can flesh do to me?
Excellent. Okay. So there is our first remedy to the ill of evil, vicious tyrants. We trust in God and we praise him with our words. And a particularly nice way to do that is with song. Or if you're prone to speaking in tongues, you know, if that's a thing, if you understand that, that is an excellent way. I know at the beginning of the Troubles, the Lord led to me to, and I may be coming up, if I'm restating a point, we'll restate it. Second Chronicles 20:20. When there was, Joash was in the battle and things looked really bad. And the Lord said this very thing, it's this very idea. You go and send your worshipers out first. Start praising me. Yeah. Start thinking of my goodness. And that starts to turn the trials that we're facing. They don't disappear. I mean, if you're in... I have a friend right now. Her husband's in the hospital. He's very, very ill. You're still in the hospital. We got some very serious situation, right? But that recollection, we're not alone. And it takes something that's very, overwhelming. And we say, there's a trust element. There's a trust element.
Yeah. It's so edifying.
It is.
Just to spend time singing and remembering.
That's right. All right. Verses 5 and 6, please.
All day long they injure my cause. All their thoughts are against me for evil. They stir up strife. They lurk. They watch my steps as they have waited for my life.
Correct. Sometimes it is hard for good people. So this, I know Micah here. I know myself. I know my family. We have a real hard time understanding because we're good people. And that's just that's not being boastful. That's just that's how we want to conduct ourselves. And we have a real hard time understanding evil and how evil people present themselves in the world, right?
Yeah.
And we don't understand their motivations and thought process. And this ignorance, if it's left unchecked, will leave us and those entrusted to us vulnerable. So David is recalling, this is really how evil people operate. I don't think people go around and plot, having evils, they're lurking and watching steps, but there are those who do that. And our Lord in Matthew 10:16 said, we need to be wise as serpents and gentle as doves. So we need to be aware of how evil doers can operate, mostly to be able to protect ourselves and those entrusted to us, right?
Yeah.
Without, getting sucked into that, but I don't know if you're listening. I don't think you will be.
It makes me think of like Jung, Carl Jung and the shadow, the idea of realizing one's own capacity for evil, as a sort of way to remedy and refuse it, but being aware what causes this or what am I even capable of, as someone who wants to conduct myself in a good manner, I still need to remember I'm capable of darkness, and I want to combat that by being aware of it and realizing I need a helper.
That's correct. That's right. That is right. All right, my friends, in the next episode, we're going to pick up with verse 7 in Psalm 56, till the fides ad ratio.